Yes, I'm having to read this. Before you worry about it, it's not three pages long, it's just three pages of the same one. I just had a bit of protection going on here. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. For all of you who I haven't met, just remember my name. Yeah, I'm Jim. I'm Aunt Adele's dad. Right?
Yeah.
Okay. On behalf of my spectacular wife, Val, I'd like to welcome you to all of you to thank you for coming to join us on this very special occasion to celebrate the marriage of our daughter Adele to Phil. First, I would like to say what a pleasure it is to welcome Phil's parents, Rick, Jane, along with the sisters, Jo and Julie. Or Julie and Jo, whichever way it was on the script. Yeah,
yeah, she's maid of honour, she's first.
That's all right, that's the one, yeah. And of course, friends and relatives of both families who have travelled both near and far to be with us today. Thank you very much. Also, a special welcome to Adele's godfather, Dick Ryan. Who arrived from Australia with his family to celebrate here with us today. Thanks, Dick.
Yeah.
Appreciate it. Now, as I'm one of the intro warm-up acts to this speech festival, Aaron, I'll be keeping it short. Like I say, it's not three pages, it's only the one. And a big thank you must go, first of all, to Adele and Phil, who had very, very definite ideas of how they wanted today to work out and what they wanted. The details, unbelievable. Through their thoughtful planning and tireless efforts, they have made this a tremendous success for everyone today. Yeah. Val and I are so proud. What about help? To see her looking beautiful, radiant, and happy. During the time we've known Phil, we've come to realise how special he is to Adele. What a great son in law he's going to be. Told you, weren't used to this. Moving right along. Can't say now. Hang on a minute. Oh yeah, right, yeah. Adele, this is the time when she's thinking, oh God, now what's he gonna say? Is he gonna say this and is he gonna say that? Well, Adele, I'm just moving aside here now. No, I'm not gonna say anything. You're alright. So I won't be spilling any beans on their past triumphs, of which there are many, or their setbacks, which are too few to remember. So sorry folks, no juicy goss today.
But see me later, I
think. But I am going to say this to Adele. Thanks for the special honour today.
Welcome.
The ride down to the church and when the two of us together was great. I remember it forever. You look great. Thank you, darling.
I learned it from Phil.
That's well used today, Phil. It's been had everyone.
Yeah.
Adele is a wonderful daughter. She's provided with so much joy and laughter over the years. We've always been proud of her. And everything she does, she always gives 110%. Right.
120.
Oh. You better sort this out because I'm not going to be blubbering all over this bloody tape.
Never don't forget, you don't have to pay for
it
anymore.
Yeah. No, they said this is a part of the speech I'm supposed to offer these people who are wiser than we are, our advice. Well, my advice to you both is this. Buckle up and enjoy this mystery ride you're on. That your life together as a married couple will give you. For sure there'll be hills to climb and roll down, but always remember it's about the journey. And any destinations are just milestones.
Thanks, Dad.
Let me have a drink.
It's wine there, not wine.
I think it's about now I should, it's way overdue. Formally welcome Phil to our family. Don't you think?
Yeah.
Welcome, Phil.
Thank you.
Most welcome.
Thank you.
Now to say this is the last part is a right toast, right? Yeah. we got a drink, haven't we? Yeah. Okay. Yeah, we got a drink. It's my very great privilege to propose a toast to our daughter and new son-in-law. So, Adele and Phil, or should I say, Mr. and Mrs. Scott.
Scott.
So here's to Phil, and should I say, Mr. and Scott. Yeah, I'm read that line, haven't I? Yeah, all right. Hang on a minute. Easy, don't get ahead. Here's to the past for all that you've learned. Here's to the present for all that you've shared. And here's to the future for all that you can look forward to together. Ladies and gentlemen, I give you Adele and Phil, a bride and groom.
First of all, thank you, Jim, for those kind words. Really, really nice, really nice. And thank you also for giving me your blessing to marry your beautiful daughter. I promise I'll always look after her and never bring her back as we agreed. But joking apart, we'd both like to thank you and Val for your great generosity towards this lovely day. Thank you very much. The next people I'd like to thank are my mum and dad, Rick and Jane, for your love and support, not only for today, but for all of my life. And I just want to say I love you very much. So, thank you, Dad. Now, I'd like to tell my wife how absolutely stunning you look. I knew you'd look beautiful, as you always do, but nothing prepared me for how you looked when you stood by my side in church today. I'm so proud to be your husband and to call you my wife. Can I have a kiss? Now I have a new phrase which I've been dying to use, so there goes. On behalf of my wife and I'd like to welcome you all here today. A day which we'll both cherish and remember for a long, long time to come. Well, that goes for Adele. I'll try and remember as much as I can, for as long as I can. You know what my memory's like. it's great to see so many friends and family, and like Jim said, some of which travel from across the other side of the world. And Dick and your family, that's really appreciate that. And also, my Uncle Rob, my Uncle Peter, and their families travel from down south to be here today. But regardless of how far you've travelled, we both appreciate the effort that everyone's made to be here. Also, it's nice to see so many of Adele's friends from work. Where's all the KLM crew? Over there? Through there? Yeah. And there's one guy that I work with. Matt. You can tell he's got the most friends. But that just shows what sort of person Adele is. That considering she's only been in the UK for about 10 years, she has so many friends that want to share in her happiness and genuinely enjoy doing so. This is because she's such a happy and jolly person to be around. And that's what attracted to me, and that's what attracted me to her in the first place. And the fact that she's a really, really good cook. but not only that, she's kind, generous and a thoughtful person who has the highest of morals and standards. Adele, I'm so proud to be your husband. I'm looking forward so much to spending the rest of my life with you. I can remember when we first met. It was in London. I was going to Germany with work and had a day spare. Adele and Julie had arranged to stay at my Uncle Rob's so they could go into London sightseeing. But knowing Adele, probably just shopping. From the very start, we hit it off. I remember thinking what a beautiful and fun person she was to be around. I think the feeling was mutual and we both enjoyed each other's company. And Julie, she was there as well. Well, everything was going great. We even went to a lovely restaurant in Chinatown. Then Adele introduced me to a new concept. She wanted to share my food. Just when I thought it was all going so perfectly, she took some of my chips and the best bits of my crispy duck. The next day, we was up early and off to Germany. Well, I was, not Adele. I had a good couple of days wandering around the Audi factory, pondering the food sharing ordeal. But as time went on and the more it happened, the more I got used to the idea. And now I'm so glad I have, because marriage is all about sharing, and now I'd share anything and everything with Adele. and my food, yeah. Now it's time for the thank yous. First of which is to the bridesmaids, which Julie, Joe, Ruby, and Rui, just over there. So, ladies and gentlemen, would you please rise while I propose a toast? To the bridesmaids.
Bridesmaids. Yeah.
Thank you.
We sit.
Yeah, you can sit. Next is a big thank you just to my sister Julie, because if it wasn't for her, I'd have never met Adele in the first place. So thank you, Julie. Thank you. And KLM, yeah. I'd like to thank George and Ren for the excellent help in church. Thank you. Thank you, Ren. Yeah. To my two best men, Phil, for keeping the ring safe and doing an excellent job of showing people to the seats. And Aaron, for being by my side today and arranging an excellent stag do. And hopefully for making a speech full of lovely comments about me. The last and the biggest thank you is for Adele. You've worked so hard and put in so much effort. I want you to know how much I appreciate all you've done to make this day so wonderful. Thank you very much. I couldn't have done it without you.
Right, I've known Phil all his life and I've looked after him. I've seen him drink from a bottle. I've even cleaned his ass. But that's enough of the stag do. That's all I'm going to say. Right, ladies and gentlemen, let me start by personally congratulating the bride and groom. If you feel as if you can't, like, look at me, just these glasses, I can take them off. It has been a great opportunity and I am personally like touched that to be involved in this special day. So I also thank you all for coming today, and for those that don't meet, I'm Aaron, I'm Phil's best man, I've known him for a long time, and I drink Foster's, by the way.
Lots.
It's been a great service and a wonderful reception so far. I'm a tad emotional, which left me kind of speechless, which is a bit inconvenient at this precise moment, Phil. So I'm stood up here and I'm going to reveal all of Phil's past misdemeanours. And for those people that don't know what misdemeanours mean, Paul, probably you, it means Phil's past wrongdoing. And for those that know Phil, he loves dressing up as women, but I'll cover that later on. But what I am going to talk about is Phil's achievements. And you needn't worry, everybody, my speech will soon be over. Phil's greatest achievement by far today is marrying Adele, who, may I say, looks absolutely stunning. Phil, you've done well, mate. You've married somebody who is beautiful, intelligent, charming. She's got a great job. Possible for a cheap honeymoon there, mate. And Adele, you've married Philip Scott. Whoever said marriage is supposed to start out balanced. Now, I do find it curious that all best man speeches I've heard are set out to demolish the character of the groom. So, frankly, I see no reason why mine should be any different. So, if there's anyone in this room who's feeling a bit queasy, apprehensive, or even nervous for what lies ahead, then it's probably because she's got married to Phil. Right, now I'm sure you all agree that it's been a great privilege. We're all here today to celebrate Phil and Adele's wedding. And Adele, you do look beautiful. And also the barmaids look beautiful. Sorry, the bridesmaids. Phil, you don't look too bad yourself, mate, but to be quite honest, I'm a bit disappointed that you copied my outfit. Right, I'm going to be a bit of a nightmare for these videographers because I don't like to stand in one place, so I brought out my Pacific speech on Phil. Right, I have reached a pivotal point in my speech where I'm supposed to, in good taste and humour, slate the groom, so I have neither good taste or humour. So, when I wrote this speech, I did ask myself what is required of a best man speech and how should I structure it. So off I went to good old Google. And we all do it, so we're all to blame. And 30 minutes later, I had diddly squat on the best man speech. But what I did have is I had new bits from a bike, I bought bits from my house, and I subscribed to Phil's favourite magazine, Playboy. When I finally resisted the temptation to internet shopping, I did find some good words of wisdom, which were, at no point during your speech make any reference to the stag weekend, so I won't. We all know that Phil is a tad older than he actually is, and at some point, mate, today, actually said to me, you look old enough to be Adele's dad. And I don't know if that's a compliment to Adele's dad or a dig at you, but... And coming to think of it, at the age of 21, correct me if I'm wrong, Phil, you had your own allotment. I mean, what 21-year-old has their own allotment? No 21-year-olds have the time to be sowing seeds. They're also in the sexual seed, so I don't know what Phil was doing. But having an allotment does save money, and come to think of it, Phil is very money orientated. And being careful with money and being tight is two different things, and Phil, you are just tight. And when Phil passed his driving test, Rick kindly added him to his family insurance of the good old red Ford Sierra.
Yeah, I did too.
Yeah, yeah. And Phil being Phil, used to get in touch with us because he was the first one to pass his driving test. Used to phone us up using his dad's phone. Say if he wanted to go down the prom, driving up and down the high street of the prom, thinking was cool because Phil's the first one to drive his car. But what little did we know, as we used to get into his car, he'd say, by the way, lads, I need you to chip in a few quid for petrol. When Rick used to pay for the fuel. So I don't know what he's done with that money, but he's probably paid for the drinks today. Phil has got very manly features. He's got big nose, huge feet, shovelless hands. He's got a hairy chest, which I may add is shaved in the shape of a Union Cross before. St. George Cross, you have? But he's got the tendency to dress up as women. And what I'm going to do at this point, Phil, if you could kindly assist me. Yeah? Yeah, no, Phil, the best man, Phil. I want you just to hand these out to tables and with a pencil. But what I ask you all, please, a bit of courtesy, is have a look at these photos. Don't make any comments until after my speech. Then 5 minutes after my speech, I'll collect them in and the winning table will get a free bottle of wine or drinks. Phil will pay for them. Thank you very much.
No doubt.
Yeah. Right, the stag night. I ignored that words of wisdom, so I'm just going to go for it. Phil constantly changes mind on the location of stag night, and I think it was a ploy to... We went to the Lake District and we went to Manchester, and it was perfectly, mate, your ploy to have a quiet night in the Lake District, which all the people who went on the stag, some of them are here today, we set out to like hammer Phil, and we did. And Phil was in bed on the Friday night at 11 o'clock. And the reason why that was because we were just drinking shots all night. I was the instigator of that. I ordered 7 shots of water and 1 shot of vodka endlessly. And you can obviously tell who drank the vodka all night. But however, when we went to Manchester, we had a fruitful night. And that's all I'm going to say on Manchester because I don't want to cause any arguments with people's misses, future wives or whatever. But what I am going to say is that people, as we checked out the rooms in Manchester, because I booked the hotels, I courteously checked everyone's room. And what I did find is the following item, and I believe Mike and Sean shared the same room. Yeah? But what I did find, lads, is a pair of knickers. And I know I didn't get a tax with you, but you two must have had a great night. And why weren't I involved? No, you didn't. So share it between yourself. I don't know. Right, I'm not going to keep on blabbing about Phil's past because, frankly, it's boring. His future looks a lot brighter with Adele. So, Phil, I can only thank you for being my best friend, mate, all my life. And you are a genuine, really nice lad. And I wish you all the happiness with Adele. Right, I've reached that part in my speech, thank you very much, Phil, where I'm supposed to give the newlywed some advice. So I will do. I am genuinely over the moon that you two are married today, and if I can offer you 2 bits of advice, the following are: no matter how far you're away from each other as newlyweds, you're never alone. So Adele, that applies to your job. No matter where you are in the world, you're never alone. And secondly, foreplay is not always optional. So considering you've been together for 4 years, the best advice I can give you both is carry on what you're doing because it's working perfectly. You're so happy today and everyone can see that. So just carry on what you're doing. And I'd like you both just to stand up right now. Just go on, stand up. A bit thirsty. Hold each other's hands. Gaze into each other's faces. Go on. Because statistically, looking into the eyes, the person that is most likely to murder you. And I hope, sincerely, it does not happen. And all my life that I've known Phil, I cannot say a bad word about him. And as a parent's perspective for a daughter, I know that Jim would want Adele to find someone who is kind, considerate, and the list is endless. And to be honest, Adele's found that person. And I think Adele, Phil, you've found Phil, so to say, and he is a perfect person for you. And also, Phil is a credit to his family. So Jane, Rick, you've obviously raised Phil, and yeah, you should be very proud of that. So, on behalf of the bridesmaids and myself, I'm guessing you bridesmaids want me to toast for you. I would like to thank Phil and Adele for involving us in this special in your special day. So, I know that you both put a tremendous amount of effort in, and we all really appreciate it. So, ladies and gentlemen, it gives me immense pleasure for all that you can upstand and raise a glass for the newlyweds, Mr. and Mrs. Scott, the bride and groom.